Hello guys, in the iterative constructs there are three loops: while loop, for loop and do while loop. So for any loop there are three things. One is initialization of the counter variable, then condition and loop terminating statement. So depending on the positions of these three things, three loops are there: while, for and do while. So in case of while loop, initialization is outside the loop. So first thing will be initialization of counter variable. After that I will write while keyword, then I will give parenthesis, and inside the parenthesis I will write the condition, and below that I will write a block of loop. Loop terminating statement will be inside the loop body. Now here you can have multiple initializations or you can have multiple statements to terminate the loop, but condition will be only one. So that is the important thing that you have to remember. So let's see few examples of while loop.
Let's see the execution of while loop. Again, say suppose I have some variable int I equals to 1, then I write while is keyword, inside parenthesis I say I less than equals to 10 value, and in the body of while loop I write say printf hi or say hello, and I close the while loop. So if I execute it, the name of the file is while.c, printf spelling is wrong. So suppose if I execute, then this will give me infinite loop. It is going on printing hello world because this condition is true and it is printing hello. Then again I value is 1, so this condition is always true because 1 is going to be always less than 10. So in loop I should have some statement which will terminate the loop after a certain number of iterations. So I will write this I++ here, and now it will print hello 10 times because after 10 number of iterations of this while loop the condition will become false. So instead of printing hello, if I write or if I print the value of I itself, here I write printf %d / n comma I, then what it will print? So in this case, compile, run, this is printing 1 to 10 numbers. Now how is that? Initially value of I is 1, then it is less than 10, so it will print 1 here. After that I++ will make value of I as 2. Again it will go to the starting point of the loop. It will check the condition again, 2 is less than 10, so it will print 2. Value of I will become 3. So again it will go at the beginning, it is less than 10, so it will print 3, and so on. So it will print the value of I, which is range from 1 to 10. Now suppose if I want to print multiplication table of some number, say num. So I declare one more variable int num, and that value I take it from the user. So I ask user, say enter number, and I scan it, scanf %d comma ampersand num. If I want to print the table of that num number, then only one change I need to make here in this code. Instead of printing I will print num into I. So how come it is num into I? Previously this was printing I value which was from 1 to 10. Now every time I want that value to be multiplied with num value, so that will print the multiplication table of the number num. So let me check, compile, run. If I enter 5, this will print 5, 10, 15, 20 and so on. If I enter 9, it will print multiplication table of 9. So this is how you can implement some logic using a while loop. Suppose I have one more variable which is j variable initialized with 10 value, and now here I write comma j greater than 5, and in the body I decrement j value. So previously it was printing 10 terms in multiplication table. Now let's see what happens if I compile this. J minus minus semicolon. If I compile and run this, then it is printing only first 5 terms of that multiplication table. This is because the second condition goes false after 5 number of iterations. So if multiple conditions are there, it won't throw any compile time error, but it will consider only rightmost condition. So anyways, because this condition is not considered, there is no sense to write that over there. So better option is I will write only one condition in a loop. So this was about the while loop. So if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.